Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Patricia and today I'm so excited to share with you guys my fall and winter haul from Aritzia. If you're new here and you like my videos, don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. It would really help my channel grow. If you're returning to my channel, thank you so much for your support. You have no idea how much each comment, like, subscriber means to me, and I really just want to say thank you. Aside from that, let's get started. So as usual, before I start this haul, I'm gonna give you guys a bit of a breakdown of what I got. And the more I do this, the more I realize how different my style can be. I can go from wearing loungewear to looking like I'm going to a business meeting in the matter of hours. So I'm pretty sure this haul covers many different types of styles. So of course I had to hop on the trend and get myself a pair of leather pants from Aritzia. So I got some leather pants, I got some blazers, some more professional and work related clothes. I got a couple of turtlenecks, sweaters, cardigans, jeans, and a little bit of loungewear. All right guys, let's get started. Okay, so starting with what I'm wearing, I purchased this black zip up from TNA and I love it. So this shirt is made of a bit of a thicker rib material, which feels really comfortable and nice for fall and winter. It's also a little bit cropped, but not too cropped. And I love the zipper on this top. You can wear this top zip down like this, but you can also zip it up like this and wear it like a turtleneck, and I love the versatility of it. I think that this top goes so well with jeans, with leather pants like I'm wearing, but you can also pair it with some joggers if you're looking for a more casual look. And it's quite inexpensive for Aritzia pricing, so I would say if you can, definitely get it. So of course when I find something that I like, I have to purchase it in another color. So I got the same zip up in the white, and again, love it just as much as the black. The only thing I would say about these tops is to size up in them. I personally usually get a small in the fitted tops from Aritzia, and I went with a medium for this one just because I didn't want it to be too tight and I wanted to have some room to breathe and not feel so restricted. I did try on a small and I just had such a hard time zipping it up and I felt like it was too restrictive. But overall, love these tops. Okay, and after many, many, many types of leather pants that I've tried on from Aritzia, I finally found a pair. Okay, so these are the Funk leather pants and they are the only ones that I've tried on so far that I actually like from Aritzia. So of course I've tried on the Melina pants, and if you don't know which ones I'm talking about, I'll insert a photo because everyone has been talking about these pants. I swear everyone's mom, grandma, sister, dog, cat owns these leather pants. So I tried them on and I thought they would be the perfect leather pants if everybody seems to be buying them, but they fit me so awkwardly. They were really large on my waist and they were short on me and they were tight on my thighs, and all around it was just an awkward fit. So I tried to find another pair and I came across these pants. So what I like about these pants is that they're a little bit of a baggier fit and they're long enough to actually cover my ankles. They fit really perfectly around my waist, but at the same time they're baggy, which has been so hard for me to come across. The only thing I would say is that if you are shorter, you might have to get these taken in unless you want the baggy look, because they will for sure be long at the bottom. Other than that, love them. Okay, so next up, I got this cropped black turtleneck from Sunday Best. It's called the Freshman Turtleneck, and honestly, I don't see why you wouldn't buy it because it's $35 and it's so, so soft. Personally, I love turtlenecks in the fall and winter, and I just think they're such good pieces to have. They're so versatile, so this is also another great purchase. Okay, so next up, I got a cardigan, and it's this Alessia cardigan. It has some puffed sleeves and it's cinched in a little bit at the arms. It has a round neckline with some cute buttons, and I just love it. I think this is such a great cardigan to have. You can wear it buttoned up, you can wear it a little bit more buttoned down, and you can just pair it with so many different types of outfits. I actually wore this cardigan with these leather pants on Thanksgiving already, and I think that this is just such a great piece to have in your wardrobe. You can also pair it with jeans, with a skirt, with work wear, just so many possibilities. Definitely love this cardigan. Okay, and next up, I got another black turtleneck, which is this turtleneck by Wilfred. It's called the Nova turtleneck, and it's okay at best. So what I don't like is the fit of this turtleneck at the bottom. Unless you're always gonna be tucking this top into your pants, I don't see how else you would wear it because it's just so flowy at the bottom and I don't think it looks too good. So what I do like about it is the material. It's a really nice ribbed, soft material, but if the fit is not good, the material doesn't matter. I wanted to buy this turtleneck to replace the Rebecca turtleneck, which they also have, because that one is just so expensive. It's about $140 for a cropped turtleneck, and I didn't want to pay that much. Sadly, this one is not a good substitute. Next up, we have another turtleneck. It's this cream turtleneck from Wilfred, and it's called the Pino Top. So judging by the photos online, I thought this will fit me a little bit differently, but I don't love it too much. So I don't know why, but I've been loving the puffed sleeves. I just think it's such a nice way to spice up just your basic turtleneck. So I thought I'd give this one a try, but it's a little bit of a weird fit on me. I might try sizing down because, again, love the material and I love the style of it, but it's just a bit too loose and just overall too baggy. Going back to the Rebecca turtleneck, I thought this would be a great substitute for it because it is a little bit more affordable, but the fit is just not the same. Okay, so up next we have my favorite purchase from this entire haul. Dun, 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 dun. So it's this beautiful matching set. It's called the Legacy Cardigan and Skirt, and I'll start with the top. So what I love about this top is, first of all, the material. It's such a nice, thick, almost bandage-like material, and it just fits so nicely on your body. I love the pearl button detailing and the contrast with the black and the white. It's just such a sophisticated set, and these things are so hard to come across. This set is straight out of Chanel. All that's missing is my brooch and my Chanel purse, and we're out the door. I wish. The skirt follows the same detailing, the same buttons, and it's just such a nice item. I think pieces like this are great because they're so timeless and elegant, and you can get so much use out of them even years down the road. If you look through Chanel's collections, they have pieces like this from 30 years ago, 20 years ago, and even to this day, they still come out with styles like these. For that reason, I think pieces like this will never go out of style, and they're so nice to have when you want to look really put together. Even though I might not need both of these right now, I still think I can use the cardigan separate from the set, and I can pair it with other skirts or other pants, and I will look really put together. So overall, love these pieces. Another piece that I purchased and I really love is this tweed skirt. So this is in the black and pastel colors, and I think this is so perfect for fall and winter. I think that with some stockings, some boots, a turtleneck, or a cardigan, this skirt can be paired with so many things and it can look so nice and professional. You can always dress the skirt up for events like Thanksgiving and holiday dinners, but you can also dress it down with just the button up and wear it to work and look really put together. So I thought I would try pairing the skirt with this matching blazer, but I don't love the blazer too much. First of all, it's a $200 tweed blazer, so if I don't love the fit of it, I'm definitely not keeping it. It has some pretty thick shoulder pads, and I don't like the way it looks when you try to close it up. Because it's tweed, I can't wear it too much, so I don't see why I'd invest $200 into it if I don't love the fit. I did have some good hopes for this one though. All right, and next up, I got this Babaton blouse, which is called the Britannic blouse, and I thought I would love it, but it's a little bit too thin for my liking. So I purchased it to wear with workwear and more professional outfits. I love the sleeves, but it's a little bit too thin for me, especially because it's white. I feel like the thinness just makes it look really cheap, and it doesn't look like it's a very good quality. It's definitely more see-through than I wanted, but I really liked the design of it. It has a tie-up belt, and it has these really nice, longer, flowy sleeves, which I think look really elegant, but again, the material could be better. Next up, we got three black blazers. So I'll start with this one. It's this black blazer from Wilfred. It's called the New Margot Blazer, and this one is a no for me. I do love the double-breasted look and how structured it is, but it's so thick to the point that it's almost a coat. This blazer is so heavy and thick that it actually hurts to be holding it for so long. And because I wanted an everyday black blazer, this is just not it for me. So the second blazer I tried out was this Shirelle blazer by Wilfred. Now keep in mind, I got this in a small, so this is really oversized. It's very flowy and oversized, and the material just looks a bit too casual for what I wanted, so it's not perfect for me. However, if you're looking for more of a casual blazer jacket, this is definitely a good choice. And the third option is my favorite option. So it's this black blazer from Babaton. It's called the Samuel belted blazer. It does have a belt, but I don't think I'm always going to wear it with a belt. and overall, I just think it's a nice blazer. I think this is a blazer worth investing to because it's a bit more stylish than your typical office blazer, and personally, I just like the way it looks on me. I think that a quality black blazer is such a versatile piece to have in your wardrobe, and it can last you for such a long time, so I really don't mind investing into a piece like this. Guys, I mentioned this in my last video, but seriously, drink your water because you have no idea how much you're probably under drinking every day. You want to maintain healthy skin, nails, just overall healthy body. Get yourself a bottle like this from Walmart for $3 and just drink your water. Alright, so next up, I got the Patty Mid-Rise Straight Leg Jeans. I bought them because, of course, they're named the Patty Jeans, and I have to have them if my name is Patricia. Just kidding. So I've been searching for a pair of jeans that is a little bit longer and actually covers my ankles, and I thought I'd give these a try because they are 31 inches, which is longer than any of the jeans that they sell at Aritzia. First of all, they are mid-rise, so they're not completely high-rise, and they sit right at my belly button. I don't mind mid-rise jeans, but I've been wearing high-rise jeans for so long that I forgot what these are supposed to feel like. The main thing that I like about these jeans is their length. I just love how they're a lot longer than my typical jeans because a lot of them just cut me off at the ankles, and these are really perfect for that reason. So the only thing I'm debating on is the fit around my waistline area because it's a little bit too loose. I can get that taken in, but I'm not sure if that will make the hip area look very awkward. So I will be taking these to the seamstress and see if she can maybe fix them up a bit. But other than that, I love these jeans. Okay, so stepping into the casual vibes, I got this racer tank from TNA. It's cut off at the bottom and it has a higher neckline, and I just always wear tops like these at home, and they're just so versatile for casual looks. You can pair a top like this with jeans, with leather pants, with joggers, so you have so many options. It's also priced pretty affordably, so I'd say if you want it, definitely get it before it sells out. Okay, so next up, I got this cropped crew neck from Sunday Best. Originally, I purchased the sweater to dress it up with a button-up underneath, but then I realized that honestly, I don't need to spend too much money on it. I can find it at Zara, H&M, probably even Walmart, so it's really nothing special. It's a good cropped crew neck, but I think I could just find it elsewhere. And next, I got a pair of the Atmosphere shorts from TNA. I got these in the heather gray, and these are not the buttery fabric. This is the Arant fabric in the 7-inch short, and they're okay. These feel just like your common cotton biker shorts. They feel like nothing special, so I might just return them and get another one of the buttery fabrics. The buttery fabric fits so much better, and it just contours your body so much nicer. These are good for home, but I don't think I'd wear them too much outside of the house. Also, I started thinking about it, and I think that if I'd wear them for activewear purposes, the sweat stains would really show in this color, so not a fan. All right, two items left. So I got a pair of thermal joggers, and I got these in the heather chrome color. They are a nice waffle knit thermal material, but the fit is just a bit too homey for me, and I don't see myself wearing them out of the house. They're really great for home, and they fit so comfortably, but they fit a bit like pajama pants on me, so I might return them. And I'll end this haul with a complete disappointment, which are these Atmosphere ruched leggings. I'm not even sure how they approved these leggings for sale. They are so sheer that it's not a joke. I tried them on and you could literally see my full underwear. I got these because I like the ruching at the bottom, and I thought it could dress up my typical leggings that I wear at home, but these are so uncomfortable, they're so sheer, and the material is just too cottony and not stretchy at all. I'm really not a fan of these leggings, so I'm 100% returning them. I'm sorry to leave it on such a disappointing note, but that concludes my haul, and I really hope you guys enjoyed watching. If you enjoy watching my videos and you want to show some support, don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. It would mean a lot to me. Let me know in the comments down below what you thought about this haul and any pieces that you particularly liked. Also, feel free to let me know what other videos you'd like to see in the future. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.